It's an exciting return to roots for her in today's house hunt. That's also an electrifying experience for him.
I've just had a shiver go down my spine.
A good one, I hope.
Yes.
And they're both involved in the fun and games of the search.
Eyes down.
Okay.
And now, look up.
Wow.
All right.
Today I'm in Yorkshire and this is the West Yorkshire village of Saltaire, an outstanding example of a mid-19th century industrial village. Now a UNESCO World Heritage Site, Saltaire lies on the banks of the River Aire and was the brainchild of Sir Titus Salt, a wealthy textile mill owner and philanthropist who created this village to provide better living and working conditions for his employees. He even took them on day trips to the Yorkshire Dales to get away from the noise and the choking pollution of the mills. And today, 150 years on, the surrounding countryside of this beautiful region still provides a welcome escape. Historic Yorkshire was once the country's largest county, but is now divided into four counties. The landscape here is often dubbed by the locals as God's own. In the north are the stunning Yorkshire Dales, the majority of which form part of a national park. Awash with rich, lush valleys and expanses of wild heather, the Dales are dissected by a maze of dry stone walls, which are archetypal of the region. Bordering the Dales National Park in Nidderdale, man-made beauty meets nature's own to form the Gowthwaite Reservoir, a nature reserve built in the 1800s that's now protected as a site of specific scientific interest. Just south of the Dales is one of Yorkshire's striking stone-built villages, Bradley. Cottages rest on the hillside here, surrounding a mid-19th century mill that was remodeled in 2005 and is now used for housing. The village is divided into High and Low Bradley, and together they make up Bradley's Both on the route of the Leeds and Liverpool Canal. So with its rugged backdrop of breathtaking beauty, teamed with towns and villages of architectural interest, Yorkshire is an ideal destination to get away from the hubbub of city life. As well as its beautiful landscapes, Yorkshire also has some pretty attractive property prices. Detached houses across the four counties in the region cost an average of £221,000. That's a sizeable £79,000 below the national figure. And each of Yorkshire's four counties has its own story to tell. You'll find the most expensive properties in the north, with not one but two national parks, and the most affordable in the south. But it's the west part of God's own country that today's buyers want to call home. Let's meet them and find out why. Retired teachers Carol and Andy from Stoke Golding in Leicestershire met as students four decades ago.
Carol walked through the door on her first night at university, and I thought, hey, yo. And we got chatting that night, but it took us 12 months.
We were friends to start with, and then we started to go.
In your second year, and so we've 40 years we've been together.
Married for 35,
but been together for 40 years.
And now this long-standing couple have put their working lives behind them, they're enjoying precious time with one another.
And this retirement adventure we've just started has brought us close together. Now we're able to spend more time.
The next phase of our lives, yeah. Really. I'm really enjoying being free to do things that we want to do, which is travel, spend more time with the family, and hence the move to Yorkshire, where both our children live and their partners and our new granddaughter.
For Carol, the decision to move to Yorkshire is much more than relocating to a new property. She's going home.
I was born in Yorkshire, so we always said that one day we'd return there. So we decided that when we retired, we'd move closer to be amongst family. And my mum still lives in Yorkshire and my brothers, so there's lots of family ties up there.
For Andy, it's a move away from home, but one he's ready to make.
I've lived here all my life. I've lived here for 60 years. We are slap bang in the middle of the Midlands motorway network, which has got its advantages, but not necessarily where you want to be. We enjoy walking and outdoor life, and Leicestershire's got some great countryside, but it's flat, largely.
But the Dales.
The Dales are just epically beautiful.
And we look forward to climbing a few hills.
Absolutely.
We're really looking forward to joining a rambling club when we move up to Yorkshire, because we walk nearly every day, keeps us fit. Now
and we see it as a way of meeting people as well, you know, as a sort of social thing, so yes. It's important from that point of view.
And with their house on the market, it won't be long before they can make the most of the great outdoors.
And I really, really look forward to opening my curtains in the morning and thinking, wow, this is nice.
Yeah.
That'll be good. Dry stone walls, sheep fields, hills, dales, snug little cottages.
First morning waking up, I won't be able to believe it that I've actually finally come home.
It'll be exciting, it'll be really good. Let's get this thing started, let's get it on the road. Let's just get on with it. I can't wait.
Carol and Andy are moving to be closer to their son in Knaresborough and their daughter in Saltaire, so we're keeping that in mind as we carry out our search. And before we get going on our Yorkshire trip, I'm meeting them to get the lowdown on their property wish list.
Welcome to Yorkshire, Carol and Andy.
Thank you.
Let's talk about the type of property you're after. What do you want it to look like from the outside? What sort of setting do you want it to be in?
We probably need some facilities around us, so a large village, small town, not near a main road. Quite open, though, about
some ideas. Yeah, it could be an old property, pretty. We like contemporary as well. We're very open to any.
Absolutely, just looking forward to what we see today.
Yeah.
Let's go inside your new home.
Right.
What do you want it to look like?
The main thing I would really like is a large kitchen diner, in preference to a separate dining room. But if you show us something with a separate dining room, that, you know, that doesn't matter either.
I love traditional wood panelling, but Carol's not so keen.
Yeah, I like light, airy houses, not dark.
And remind me of your budget?
OK, £450 maximum, but for £450 there has to be absolutely nothing to do.
Well, we have three fantastic properties lined up for you. Okay. So let's head off.
OK,
really
thank
excited.
For their top budget of £450,000, Carol and Andy would like a character property, but they're open-minded about the exact style of house they want. Ideally, it would have a large kitchen diner and 3 to 4 bedrooms. And outside, it's a manageable garden they're after, all in a location that's close to amenities. We've tracked down a fabulous selection of properties for them to view, but each one's price will only be revealed after they've completed the tour. And their final visit to the mystery house could see them taking another trip down the aisle. We're We're starting off our property search in the North Yorkshire village of Sutton in Craven. Located in the Aire Valley, this picturesque village sits in the shadow of hills and farmland with a stream running through it. There's a history of corn milling and textiles here, and buildings display the sandstone Yorkshire is famous for, showcased in an old mill, now apartments. Locals are served by a village hall, a handful of shops, and a pub. And sitting above the village, surrounded by a wealth of countryside walks, we find our first property.
Bit different to what I was expecting.
Not what you were expecting.
Not detached.
It's not detached. This whole building is a 400-year-old barn. In the 1990s, it was converted into accommodation for people rather than animals. And the house that we're looking at is the middle house.
What a location.
Stunning.
On the top of the hill, on the top of the moor.
Looking forward to looking inside it now.
Shall we head on in?
Can't wait, thank you.
This property's position in the centre of the barn conversion means it benefits from having the original barn entrance. This takes us into a roomy hallway, which leads into an open-plan dining hall with an impressive vaulted ceiling.
Wow. Look at that view.
You can't miss it, can you? It's the first thing you see as you walk through the door.
And it's really open, isn't it? Oh. A lot of burning stone.
Yeah. Got a lovely stone fireplace. So that's the sort of winter area, I think. And then this is the sort of summer area in a way.
Social space.
Yeah, absolutely.
Really like it.
Great.
Can't wait to see more.
Let's go to the kitchen.
That's different. Yeah.
It is.
Different.
Such a contrast to the outside the property.
Yes, it's so modern, isn't
super
it?
Super modern, really sleek.
It is smaller than I was expecting from when we were out there, but you've got your dining room there.
Well, with the rest of the downstairs being so open.
Yes.
It's not so much of a problem, is it, really?
No.
So it's something you could work with?
Absolutely. Oh, yes. No, yeah, it's super.
Well, let's go and have a look where you might be sleeping.
Okay, thank you.
Also on the deceptively large ground floor, there's a room currently used for music and a shower room. Then upstairs, there's a galleried landing, another smart shower room, and three bedrooms. A snug double, a single with fitted wardrobes, and lastly, there's the master.
It's good size.
It's huge. Wow.
It really is a master suite because you've got this lovely bathroom.
Really like the bathroom too.
The more we see of the property, the more it seems to grow from the outside.
Yes. Thought, this is really
now
deceiving.
We're in, it's like, oh.
No, I really like what I've seen so far.
Great.
Can we see more?
Yes, let's go back outside because I think you'll see it with different eyes now, won't you?
Absolutely.
Definitely.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks.
The property benefits from a large garage and the rear garden features a terrace complete with pond. But before we discuss the price, we're taking a moment to enjoy the main highlight here, which is absolutely priceless.
I do hope this view is to your liking.
Well, it's spectacular.
How could it not be?
This would be ideal, really. And because you've got this view beyond, you don't need a big garden because the whole of it is like your garden, isn't it?
It is. And as the person who'd be doing the work, the smaller the better, to be fair. Somewhere to put some chairs, somewhere to put a table, somewhere to sit, and very little work. So absolutely spot on.
It's time to guess the price. Who'd like to go first?
I think you should.
OK. I think 425.
Okay, and I'm going to go for a cheeky 375.
Andy, you are closer.
Yeah.
Oh, excellent.
And you're in luck. It's actually on the market for £335,000.
Wow.
I just had a shiver go down my spine.
A good one, I hope.
Yes.
That's really good.
That's right. Okay, that's a game changer.
That is a surprise.
Go and have another look around while I enjoy the view. Right. And then I'll meet you at the front.
Okay, Liam, thank you.
Thank you.
This 400-year-old barn conversion has rung in at £115,000 under Carol and Andy's top budget. There's a fantastic open-plan living area, plus the option to have four bedrooms. And the views from the garden are simply breathtaking.
Another little room.
Yeah, it's not so small. I mean, it's an ideal potential bedroom and separate entrance just there.
I could really see myself living here. I know it's in the middle of the countryside. It's more remote than perhaps I had in mind initially. We both like walking, and just looking out of that window would make me want to go for a walk every single day.
As soon as I entered the property, the only thing that catches your eye when you walk through the door is that wall of glass and the view beyond. And, you know, if you were to say, what three things did you notice when you walked in the room, I'd say view, view and view.
Look at that smile.
Yes.
You really do love the house, don't you?
I do, I really love it, yes. It's such a surprise when we walk through the door. It's lovely.
And the price is absolutely spot on.
I almost feel guilty for taking you to see another house. Almost, but not quite. Let's go.
Okay, thank you.
In the heart of the Yorkshire Dales is the Nidderdale area of outstanding natural beauty. Covering 233 square miles, its stunning scenery makes it immensely popular with visitors wishing to take in the countryside by foot. As Carol and Andy are keen to join a rambling group when they make their move, they've come to meet Richard Hersey and fellow members of the Harrogate Ramblers Club, who are gathering to start their walk from the quaint market town of Pateley Bridge.
Well, Harrogate Ramblers, we have about 300 members, and we organise a walk on every Saturday, and then we'd have a walk between 8 and 12 miles.
And where are we walking to today?
Today we're walking from Pateley to Brimham Rocks.
Right.
Is it a strenuous walk, or...?
The first bit is uphill.
Right.
Quite steep.
We come from quite a flat area at the moment in Leicestershire, right. So hills will be a bit of a challenge
for us. Yes, you're using some different muscles, but certainly, right. You know, the backs of your calves might be having a new experience.
From start to finish, the route covers around 9 miles, and today they're taking in a few of its highlights. A perfect introduction to the highs and lows of the Dales. And as well as strenuous exercise, it's a great chance to socialise as some of the club members are joining them for part of the journey. Pateley Bridge is a great place to start. It's the beginning and end point of the Nidderdale Way, a circular route covering 53 miles through the Dales. First stop for them all on today's jaunt is St Mary's Church of Pateley Bridge.
Lovely old place, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah, it's very gorgeous. There's been a church here since about the 1300s, but about the end of the 1700s, it was falling into some disrepair, and also the parishioners were finding it very difficult walking up the steep hill. Mm. We just walked.
I agree with that.
Which is lovely. It has got what's called a devil's door over there, where the devil was supposed to leave when there's baptisms. Right. We'll be leaving now through the priest's door. The rest of the Harrogate group are going to carry on back down to Pateley, but we'll carry on to Brimham Rocks.
OK, thank you.
Okay. See you then.
Bye.
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 with the house hunting.
Thanks. Bye.
The Ramblers is a nationwide charity with over 100,000 members. It was established in 1935 after groups campaigned for people to have access to the countryside, and it put pressure on landowners to allow ordinary folk to walk across their land. Today, its goal is still to protect access to the great outdoors by foot.
Wow, what a gorgeous view.
Yes, well, it is. It's the Nidd Valley, so you've got the River Nidd in the bottom here. And it gets way over that way, and then you can also walk further up the valley. This part here is just part of the Nidderdale Way.
It's gorgeous.
Can't wait to be able to do all the walks.
Next stop is Brimham Rocks, a collection of unusual eye-catching rock formations scattered across 50 acres of moor.
Wow, Richard, what an amazing place this is.
I know, it's a kind of millstone grit. It was formed about 320 million years ago, laid down in layers. The reason that they undercut so much is because we had an ice age which lasted tens of thousands of years. And about 15,000 years ago, this valley here was full of ice. But these rocks were sticking up, just proud of the glacial ice. And then you got pebbles and other things, sand being blown across by the Arctic winds, which have undercut this rock and have also taken out some of the softer areas of the sandstone you can see higher up.
Looks like you could almost push it over.
It does.
Balancing on that smaller rock at the bottom.
But it weighs 180 tonnes. I don't know how they worked that out, but that's what they say.
And just a little further down the path, the rocks can be truly appreciated in all their glory, even through a spot of rain.
Well, Richard, this really is an absolutely amazing place. Thank you very much for bringing us here today. Just say on the information board here that we can see York Minster on a clear day.
Okay.
But we've lost that, I'm afraid, now. But it is a spectacular place, and I hope you'll come back. And I'll look at it again when the sun's out.
But thanks, we've really enjoyed it.
Good, I'm glad you've had a good day.
Yeah, thank you.
Now it's time to ramble back to our house hunt. Our next property stop takes us into West Yorkshire, to the village of Wilsdon. Perched on the hillside and rolling down into the valley, Wilsdon paints a picture of a classic Yorkshire landscape. Surrounded by farmland, there's evidence of the mills of yesteryear on the horizon. There's also a church here, a small choice of shops, a pub, and there are plenty of country walks on offer with beautiful scenery at every twist and turn. And just on the edge of the village is our second house.
Very pretty.
Very, very pretty.
It is.
Isn't it
just? How sweet.
Yes.
This is also a barn conversion.
Right.
So it dates back to 1750 and was converted into a home in the 1970s.
Right.
But again, you've got brilliant views.
It is.
It is.
The other thing to mention is, of course, that it is attached on one side.
It is, yes. However, I
that
may
doesn't
have,
daunt you anymore.
I may have learned my lesson from the previous.
You're
property.
Over that now,
over
aren't
that,
you?
Yeah, not
exactly.
A problem. Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, let's get inside then.
Okay, thank you.
This attractive stone barn was originally the milking parlour for the local farm, and we're beginning our tour of it in the rather grand and lofty entrance hall.
I thought we should stop in this hallway because they've made a really nice feature of the entrance, I think.
How many houses can you buy? We can put a sofa in the hallway.
Exactly. It's quite hotel-like, isn't it?
Oh, can't wait some more.
Let me show you the lounge.
Okay, thank you.
How's this for a sitting room?
Oh, wow, it's a good size.
With this fireplace as the feature.
Really striking, very grand as well. Nice and central and dual aspect. Excellent.
It doesn't feel hugely barn-like.
But it feels really cosy.
Yeah.
And comfy.
Warm, inviting.
Warm. Yes,
more,
yes.
Homely.
The other thing about this house, it really does flow nicely.
OK.
So let me take you through the dining room.
Oh, yes, please. Lovely. Right. Oh, wow. This really? Is a killer kitchen.
It's so light, isn't it? And spacious. I can imagine, you know, while we're cooking, having the family rounds, all sitting together and... Yes, really.
Very social space.
And I like the sink, the position of the sink as well. It's quite unusual, isn't it, being
it
there?
It is, actually.
While, you know, eating dinner, you can be at the sink washing up.
That's my life, then.
After he served you.
Yeah.
Shall I show you where he's going to be serving you breakfast in bed?
Good idea.
Just off the kitchen, there's a utility room, and then moving upstairs, there's a fully tiled bathroom and three bedrooms, all in the eaves. At the back, there's a bright double and a single, which currently serves as a study. Then at the front of the house is the master.
Good size.
Very good size. It's lovely.
Actually, it comes with its own dressing room.
Right. Oh.
That I guess wow. I guess for some families would be a nursery, but actually it's a lovely dressing room right. And there's an ensuite.
I really like the windows, and look at the little windows at the bottom as well.
They're really sweet, aren't they?
Yeah. You could lie in bed and look up and
little doors on.
Let's head back outside and talk about how much this might set you back.
Okay. Right.
Do you want to lead the way?
I will.
Thank you.
The split-level garden includes a lush lawn surrounded by mature trees and hedges, a walled pond, pebbled seating area, and pretty flower beds, all with panoramic views.
So with this property, there's no front and back garden. This is everything.
Right.
Your front entrance, back entrance, everything, because this is the south-facing bit.
Yeah.
It's still quite private, though, isn't it? You're not really overlooked or...
But you
so quiet,
can do
it?
Some overlooking.
Yes,
I mean, the view down there is fabulous.
I know, it's amazing. Mm.
A lovely landscape.
Yes.
His and her sheds.
His shed more.
Well, there are two, so there really is one each, or you can have two.
Right.
So we need to discuss price, don't we?
Do.
How much is this property on the market for?
Mm. Well, I'll go first this time.
Okay.
I'm going to go for 445.
Right, well, I overestimated last time, so I'm going to go lower, and I'm going to say 425.
OK. Again, Andy is closer, and I've done what you've asked. I've used up your whole budget because there is nothing to do. So it's on the market for £450,000. So, now that you know the price, have another look around and discuss whether you want to use your whole budget.
OK.
And I'll meet you in a bit.
Brilliant.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This converted barn, thought to date back to the 17th century, is priced at the top of Carol and Andy's budget. It gives them both character on the outside and style on the inside, including a fabulous open-plan kitchen diner and three bedrooms. The garden is a good but manageable size, and the views are stunning.
They got this as an office, but I guess we could have it as a third bedroom.
Yeah. Make a really good-sized single room. You probably could get a double bed in here.
Certainly in the future, I can see Carol and I and family in here just enjoying the space, enjoying each other's company. When we walk into a property, Carol and I know fairly quickly if it's going to be a place for us. And we got that feeling straight away. This house is definitely calling out to us. We really like it.
The views here, the hallway as you come in, and looking out with that lovely glass door overlooking all the beautiful dales, it's gorgeous.
I think it's been quite a successful day.
It has.
It has. Two, although similar properties, but actually both with different things to offer. Really, really interesting and quite thought-provoking as well.
Should we go mull over things with a glass of something?
That sounds like a plan to me.
It's day two of our Yorkshire road trip, searching out a rural retreat so that Carol and Andy from Leicestershire can live closer to family. And with a top budget of £450,000 to spend, we've already shown them two characterful properties. But all their prayers could be answered with our mystery house.
I can't think of anything to say. It's just absolutely stunning.
You are quite speechless.
And later, I'll be finding out how Iceland meets Yorkshire in the Dales.
Oh, there's something very satisfying about this.
Andy and Carol were certainly expressing enthusiasm for both of our properties yesterday, with house number two quickly surpassing house number one in their minds. But I do feel they're holding back a little bit, and I can't quite put my finger on why. But I'm hoping our mystery house and its location will convert them from being cautious into candid. What do you think I have up my sleeve for the mystery?
Well, I think it could be something like an apartment.
And I think it's a new build.
Do you think I'm going to go right away from barn conversions?
Yes.
There were two barn conversions yesterday. I am hoping you're going to stir the pot a bit and see what comes up this time.
But you liked them both so much.
Yeah, we did.
We did.
I mean, that's absolutely correct. But it is the mystery property.
And final property stop, we're off to the market town of Sorby Bridge. Just over 10 minutes away is the attractive market town of Hebden Bridge, which lies on the Rochdale Canal. There were many water-powered weaving mills here in the 19th and 20th centuries, and at one time, Hebden was known as Trouser Town because of the abundance of clothing manufacturers here. Today, there's still evidence of the town's industrial past, along with more up-to-date independent shops and eateries. The area is popular for walking and cycling, and in recent years, the Tour de France passed through on its way from York to Sheffield. I've brought Carol and Andy to the waterside to see what they could have at their disposal.
There's a connection between Hebden Bridge and the Mystery House, because a couple of the architects that were involved in the Mystery House also were involved in the building of the bridge.
That's intriguing.
Yes.
So there is a nice link, but I thought we could have a walk around.
Yes.
And then drive the 10 or 15 minutes over to the Mystery House.
Okay, great.
In Sorby Bridge, we find our rather outstanding mystery house, and it's so unique that I want it to be a true surprise for our buyers.
Right, eyes down.
Okay.
And now, look up.
Wow.
No way.
That's a very imposing building.
I'm sticking with the conversion theme.
Right.
But it's not a barn conversion, of course. It actually was a Methodist chapel.
Okay.
At the moment, it's two houses,
right.
So the whole of the right-hand side is on offer.
Okay.
That's big.
How would you feel about living in a converted chapel?
Majestic. Especially with those views behind.
Absolutely. And you can see from the height of the home,
the views that you would have.
Yes, it just looks fantastic.
Let's go in.
Okay, thank you.
This magnificent mystery house, built from Yorkshire stone in 1822, speaks for itself. The chapel was rebuilt in 1897, influenced by French Renaissance style, but its conical towers are art and craft in design. It closed its doors as a place of worship in 1979 and was later converted into two homes. The interior is a complete contrast to the outside and is currently vacant.
Now, to make the most of those glorious panoramic views outside, the house has been designed upside down, really. This would be your master, and in the turret, you've got that beautiful circular room that you can turn into anything, really.
Yeah.
Have the world's biggest walk-in wardrobe.
How do you feel about upside down living?
It's fine, yes.
Oh, we like something a bit quirky.
Let's go. More, please.
Also on the ground floor are a further two bedrooms, one double and a single. They're both served by a fully tiled bathroom. This is actually a three-story property, and there's another bedroom found up in the eaves on the second floor. And all the bedrooms sandwich the first floor, where we find the living quarters, featuring a huge sitting room, which is overlooked by a galleried mezzanine level.
How's this for a living room?
Spectacular.
I'm just speechless.
That's one of my favourite areas over there.
You see the sun just streaming through sun the windows track. All the time.
Should we go and have a look inside?
Yes.
Next door is another circular room with a decorative solid wood floor, an amazing outlook and timber panelled walls, something that was on Andy's wish list.
I think I'd spend all day sitting in here.
I can't think of anything to say. It's just absolutely stunning.
You are quite speechless.
For once.
For once. The thing that neither of you have mentioned so far, though, is the kitchen, is so important to you. Shall I show you that, or shall we just put an offering on?
We'll get out of it.
Just to be polite.
Through the main reception room and up on the mezzanine level is a shower room, but on this floor there's an ultra-modern bathroom, and then at the other end of the expansive living room is a smart and contemporary kitchen.
It looks small compared to the rest of the rooms we visited. However, it's actually very useful and very... Well, it's a big kitchen. There's loads of cupboards. It's all there.
Yeah, I like it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Should we go and enjoy more of the view outside?
Thank you.
Outside, there's a balcony on the first floor, and a raised deck terrace overlooks the landscaped gardens. Next door are reminders of the house's former life as a chapel.
It's been all about the views the past couple of days.
Certainly has.
And this one is...
Just continues the theme.
It's just spectacular.
If you were to go for it, how much would it cost?
I think, once again, you've pushed the budget, and possibly even more. I think 465.
OK.
I'm going to say 399.
Oh, gosh. We're bang on budget again. It's on the market for £450,000, so it would be your entire budget.
And that's absolutely understandable as well, because it's huge.
It's
a really...
And a one-off.
Yeah, it's really unique. Now that you know the price, have another look around, and then I shall come and see you.
OK.
All right.
Thank you.
See you in a bit.
The mystery house is priced right at the top of Carol and Andy's budget, but it offers them something quite exceptional. It's got undeniable character outside, with a spacious, contemporary interior and four bedrooms, Plus, in the pretty garden, there are views galore from every aspect.
When we pulled up and we were allowed to look at the property, I thought, wow, it looks like a castle, fairy tale. When we started the tour, I was just bowled over. The size of the rooms, the number of the rooms, the character in the place. But after a while, and as Carol and I wandered around, we tried to imagine what it'd be like to actually live in that house. Just the two of us, and most of the time, it began to dawn on us that actually it may be a step too far.
I've never envisaged myself living in a property like this. As we were walking around the rooms, I was thinking, wow, this place is amazing, and it'd be great to show it off to the family and friends. But then, as we went into different rooms, I was thinking, practicalities of the place, you know. I just don't think it's for us, really, because it's too big.
Well, I'm really curious about what you're going to do next, so let's go and have a cup of tea somewhere and a proper chat.
Great okay. idea.
Thank you.
It's not unusual to see grazing cattle on the horizon of the Yorkshire landscape. And in the heart of the Dales, a young Yorkshireman is using his cattle's yield to produce a dairy product that legend has it the Vikings introduced to Iceland over 1,000 years ago. 23-year-old dairy farmer Sam Morehouse discovered Skyr on the internet when he was looking to diversify on the family farm and decided to fly to Iceland to find out more about the product, which is somewhere between a yogurt and a cheese. Hesper Farm is currently the sole UK producer.
What made you think, actually, this is something I can do from a Yorkshire Dales farm?
Well, I mean, we had the milk, obviously.
Yeah.
And it hadn't been done in the UK yet. And it was high protein, it's a high protein product and a high calcium product and it's low in fat. So I was just sort of, you know, I'd go and find out as what I can about it. So I went over to Iceland to kind of find somebody in Iceland who could show me how to make it.
So you had to train up to do it, really?
Yeah, very much so.
The family has a herd of 300 Holstein cows, of which 160 adult cattle are milked twice a day to each produce around 35 litres of milk. This makes about 2,000 litres of Skyr a week. The family are very proud of their prize-winning girls.
He spent, you know, the majority of his life trying to breed them up to a good standard of cow. You're looking for, like, a good conformation on the, you know, good udder and legs and so on. And, yeah, occasionally we get awards.
And what about the milk? Is that assessed?
To a degree, yeah. They do look at, you know, how much milk they're producing and the quality of the milk. But that should come with it being a good cow.
The most treasured is Baby, the first cow Sam bought when he was just 14 years old. And she's the poster girl for Sam Skyr.
Baby's just led down as she likes to be, over in the grass over there.
And you can always pick her out.
Yeah, yeah, she's got quite distinctive markings, if you know what you know, if you're used to looking at cows.
And she's your baby.
Yeah, well, yeah, that's it, yeah.
It's in the dairy where Iceland meets Yorkshire and the white stuff is transformed. Skyr takes almost three times longer than traditional yogurt to make and uses around four times more milk per pot. 3 to 4 litres of milk makes a kilo of the nutritious dairy product. After being skimmed and pasteurised at a local dairy, the milk goes into the batch tank here, where it's heated before cultures direct from Iceland are added and then vegetable rennet.
This is where I should tell you, I've always made natural yoghurts at home, and what I'm quite curious about is how similar the process is.
Yeah, I mean, to degrees it will be similar, it's just sort of like there's varying steps that may have changed.
So this is the saucepan? Or the
Very
yogurt
much
maker.
So, yeah, this is where it all happens.
The mixture sits in the tank for 6 hours, where it turns to curd and is then drained into muslin sacks.
And this is where it stops being the yogurt, is it? Because that's where I would stop. I wouldn't...
Yeah.
I would then put the yogurt straight into the fridge after it sat out for 12 hours or something.
Yeah, ordinarily, that's where you'd, at that point, you'd say that's yogurt. That's what we, there's a few extra little steps involved in making skyr.
12 hours later, when the excess liquid or whey has drained out, the high-protein, high-calcium, fat-free product is born.
Uh-huh.
So this is the mixing bowl. We're just mixing some skyr now. If it's plain skyr, we just stir it, mix it up, break it up, make it smooth. And if it's a flavoured skyr, we then add fruit in at that point as well.
And what flavours do you do then?
We do vanilla, strawberry, raspberry, black cherry, and blueberry.
After it's been mixed for around 10 to 15 minutes with some sweetened fruit, the skyr goes into the filler, ready for potting.
Now that's quite liquidy.
Yeah, I mean, once this comes through and we potted it up, we'll get it into the fridge.
Back in the fridge.
Then start setting again.
Okay.
So what we'll do is we'll go a few pots. Maybe a couple, maybe.
How many pots do you normally do?
Usually we sort of fill up this table behind us, and then Claudia will be sealing them as we pour the glass. So do you want to have a crack at it?
Yeah, sure.
So you just put your foot in there.
Oh, so I could hear it twice, but I see what you mean. Something very satisfying about this.
Next, the lids are sealed on, and after a little bit of work, I think I deserve to be rewarded with a taste. First up is the original.
Love it. Would go nicely with a curry. Black cherry, your favourite.
This is my favourite, yeah.
It is just a hint of black cherry.
Yeah.
But there's enough there.
Yeah, so you know about it.
But you've got the sourness of the yoghurt still.
Yeah, so it's still like that natural yoghurt taste in it. And then finally, raspberry.
It's distinctive from the black cherry.
Yeah, it's definitely got a different sort of fragrance and flavour about it.
Sam, thank you very much for showing me the process. It's been so interesting.
No, it's been good to have you.
Thank you.
So we know our mystery house is too big for Andy and Carol, so let's find out if one of our two other properties is a good fit for them. So, where are we with the houses? I know you liked all of them, really.
We did.
But which ones are serious contenders for you now? Is it really only house number two?
It is.
I think so, yes. I mean, I loved house number one, but I think I agree with Andy that it's perhaps just a little too remote.
Lovely location, but practically day-to-day living, I just feel it's a little too far out of town.
So will you go back and see house number two?
Oh, yes, definitely.
Do you love the house enough to perhaps put an offer in if you're in a position to?
The house was lovely. It suited us down to the ground.
I think you looked at home in it.
I felt at home.
It did. It was very homely. And for a barn conversion, just felt really cosy. And I could see us relaxing there, having the whole family over. And
I like that word. I felt relaxed in it as well.
Yeah, you could just move literally straight in without having to do anything.
Well, I'm hoping you like the area then, because actually, therefore, you might have found the house.
We might have. You might have found us a house. Yes.
Yes.
Well, I wish you both the best.